Dear children, in the last class, we have studied about the geographical or physical features of India, and India is both a subcontinent and peninsula. We have also discussed about the coastal lines, foreign trade, and the diversity in the geographical environment. This is what we have learned, means we have studied or discussed in part 1 in the last session. Now, let's continue the lesson part 2. In this session, you will learn about the prehistoric period, the living style of man in prehistoric period, and the Stone Age. The prehistoric period. Here, the prehistoric period means the period before the discovery of the art of writing is called the prehistoric age. Okay, in this period, there was no linguistic development or the use of script. Script means writing. So, this period means the period before the discovery of the art of writing is called the prehistoric age. Means in this period there was no linguistic development, and there is no any evidences of the language development as well as the writing, and we do not get any written documents or written records for the study of history of this prehistoric period. Then how do we get to know about the people and their life in the prehistoric age? The scholars who study this period, they are called the archaeologists. Okay, here the archaeologists, they provide us the information about the prehistoric period. In this way, we can find out or we can know about the people of this prehistoric age through archaeologists. In this age, man was a nomad. Nomad means a nomad is someone who lives by traveling from place to place. And here, the man was indulged in hunting and food gathering. Archaeologists have discovered few tools which has been created and used by these people. Probably they used, means the prehistoric period people, they used tools which are made up of stone, wood, as well as the bones. Among these, only stone tools have survived today. Means they provide us the sources. They are the important sources for the study of this particular period, prehistoric period. Next, human beings in the prehistoric age. They used stone tools to peel the skin and separate the flesh as well as the bones of the animals. And they also used stone tools to scrape the bark of trees, means to drag the outermost layer of the trees. And they also used these stone tools to cut the fruits as well as the roots. And the people here, they used to create handles out of bones as well as the wood, and using them like spears and the arrows. And they used to hunt animals by those weapons which they have been made by using bones and wood. They used stones as axes to chop down trees and also to cut them up, to cut the trees into the logs. And they might have used wood to build huts for themselves. They also used wood to build the huts for themselves, or even they used the wood to make handles for their weapons. And the word prehistoric period, it provides this kind of vision or this kind of imagination to us. Next, where did the prehistoric men live? Here, the relics of the hunting and food gathering humans are available in Bhimbetka, Hunasagi and Kurnool in India. Here, the people, they have found the historical objects of the hunting and food gathering humans in the places like Bhimbetka, Hunasagi and Kurnool in India. And there are many other sites in which such relics have been found. Not only in Bhimbetka, Hunasagi and Kurnool, they also found in many other places in which such relics, means such historical objects have been found. Most of these sites, they have been discovered along the banks of rivers and lakes where they get water, okay, where the banks of rivers and lakes, in these places most of these sites have been discovered because water is more important for them. It may be for the human use or for the animals use or for the agricultural purpose. Furthermore, moreover, since stone tools were essential for the survival of people at that age, means in that particular, means in that prehistoric age, people more depended on the stone tools. Okay, so here most of the people, they used to live where that stones were there. And they choose areas abundant with stone which could fulfill their needs. Areas where people used stones to create various tools, they have been thought, okay, they have been believed that they were the first industrial sites of the human beings. How do we get to know about such industrial sites? Usually, we get to see stone tools around rocky areas, isn't it? Okay. People might have rejected some rocks as unsuitable for their tools. Heaps of broken rocks or stone chips obtained during the creation of such implements abound in such areas, means which has been existed in larger areas. It is possible, means it is possible that people lived, okay, it is believed that in that certain place people lived for a long time in those particular places, and these sites are called residential and industrial sites. Knowledge of fire. Here, signs of ashes have been obtained in the caves of Kurnool. And here, this place, they reveal the knowledge and the use of fire by the people of the Stone Age. Probably, fire was used for various purposes, means to cook fire, it was used to cook food for light and also to frighten the animals from dangers. Drawings found in caves. We get to see some drawings in many caves in which people used to live in the Stone Age. Even today we can see these drawings done on the walls of caves and on rocks. Such cave drawings can be seen in India. In India, such places like Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh and also in Karnataka. There are beautiful drawings of wild animals and hunting. Next, the changing environment. It is believed that 12,000 years ago, a major change took place in the earth's environment. And the earth's temperature, it began to gradually increase. Means it gradually, it slowly, the earth's temperature began to slowly increase. And this led to the development of grasslands in many places. Birds and animals began to multiply in unprecedented, means extraordinarily growth in numbers, development of these, okay, multiplied means the birds and animals began to multiply in unprecedented numbers. Animals like deer, elks, goats, sheep and others prospered, developed in these grasslands. Humans who had been hunting animals, they began to observe their nature, food habits and the way these animals multiplied, means they have been increased. Over a period of time, they captured some of these animals and brought them up, means they started to domesticate these animals. Like this, animal husbandry and dairying started. In this way, the animal husbandry and dairying were started. Humans had by now learned to catch fish in streams and lakes. Okay, and also they noticed in the meantime that some grass bearing grains had grown naturally. By observing that, they also learned to use them as foods. Okay, foods like the grains, the cereals like rice, wheat and barley obtained from such plants. Gradually, slowly, they also learned to grow them too. Okay, by observing the nature, here the early humans or the prehistoric period people, they also learned how to catch the fish and they also learned to use some grass bearing grains as food. This is the diagram which shows the stages of the prehistoric age. And here there are, firstly there are three stages, that is, first one is the old stage, middle stone age, new stone age. In the old stone age, again it is divided into three parts, that is early old stone age, middle old stone age, late old stone age. These are the important stages of the prehistoric age. Archaeologists refer to this, to the period we discussed now, okay, by different names. The age that prevailed 2 million years ago is the old stone age, oldest age, and it is also called as the old stone age, and it is stretched over a period of 12,000 years. And this long duration has been classified into three stages, that is the early, middle and late old stone ages. The period from 12,000 years to around 10,000 years is called the middle stone age. And here the tools of this period, they are generally very small and hence they are called delicate stone tools. Means in the middle stone age, the people used, the people used the tools were very small and it was also very delicate. So they are called as delicate stone tools. They used to fix these stone tools with handles made out of wood and bones. They used those tools as axes and saws. Along with these tools, tools of the old kind too continued to be used. Means the tools which they have been used in the old stone age, even that tools were also been used in this stage also, means in this middle stone age also they continued using the tools of the old stone age. And here in this middle stone age the tools were very small and it was also very delicate. Next, the new stone age, it is also called as Neolithic age. The new stone age, it began after the 10,000 years. The stone tools of this period are different from those of the earlier periods. These tools were bright, means it was shining and it also had the very sharp edges. People of this age, they used grinding stones for grinding leaves and herbs as well as to grind grains and cereals. Okay, now we use the grinding stones. In this period we use mixer grinders, isn't it? In the past they were using grinding stones. You can go through the pictures, okay, of the grinding stones. They used those grinding stones to grind the leaves, herbs, grains and cereals. Okay, some pots and pans, okay, some pots and pans of this period have been found, a few of which have been decorated. Okay, few pots and pans they have been found, and few of those pots they have been decorated. They were decorated. Pots were also used for storing grains, and they were also used for cooking rice, wheat and other grains and cereals. Okay, here the people they used in Neolithic age or in New Stone age, the people used pots for the purpose of storing grains, and they also used those pots for cooking rice, wheat and other grains and cereals. People of this age also, they had also learned to weave the cloths. Dear children, here we have completed the chapter. I hope you people have understood all the aspects of this chapter. Now, let's move on to your homework part, assignment. Here the questions are like this. Answer the following. What is meant by prehistoric age? And the next question is, how did animal husbandry and dairying start? The next question, the different periods of prehistory have been given various names by archaeologists. What are they? Dear children, understand the lesson, go through the video and then do your homework. Thank you, dear children.